back in the 60s, the in thing was to be either a mod or a rocker. Now, rockers had big greasy motorbikes and wore leather jackets, where mods had parkas like this and rode around on scooters like these. But these are no ordinary scooters, because Pulling Power has tracked down some real movie memorabilia. This is the actual scooter used by Sting in the film Quadrophenia.
Look at the scooter! That is ice!
And this fantastic Lambretta is a replica of the scooter used by Jimmy, who is Phil Daniels, also in the same film.
Now, this piece of motoring memorabilia is owned by Dave Wyburn from Gloucester. He's mad on scooters and a huge fan of the cult movie Quadrophenia. In fact, he's such a fan of the film that he's writing a book about it. And it's Dave's research for the book and his ongoing search for Quadrophenia memorabilia that put him on the trail of these awesome machines.
So then, Dave, how did you manage to find these fantastic relics?
I looked on the internet for some memorabilia, and a guy advertised a film script and some other bits and bobs from the film. When I turned up at the house, the guy mentioned to me in passing that there was a rusty old scooter there.
What type of nick was it in when you first got it then?
All the panels were rusty, the accessories were stripped off it, and you couldn't really tell it was this bike when I picked it up.
Really?
Yeah.
And what I'm driving, Dave, is a replica of Phil Daniels' scooter, Jimmy,
That's
in the
right,
film.
Mate.
And I watched the film last night and I can't tell the difference. I do believe I'm riding Jimmy's scooter.
That's as near as you're going to get to it, Mike, yeah.
It is fantastic, isn't it?
The only thing I find out with that one is you just have to look out for post office vans.
There weren't just two famous scooters in the film Quadrophenia. The eagle-eyed amongst you would have undoubtedly noticed loads of scooters in the background. And one of them was this one. This UnionJack masterpiece belongs to Roy Edwards. Not only was it used in the original film, but it was Roy riding it.
It was a chance of a lifetime, really. You know, I spent 3.5 months filming with the Who film.
3.5 months it
took? Yeah, we had a month at Brighton and 2.5 months in London. And it was really hard work, you know, night scenes and day scenes as well. Some used to cross over, so we, you know, sometimes you didn't get any sleep, you went from the night scene to the day scene. There was a lot of hanging about when bits weren't going right and the weather was wrong and that, but it was just a fantastic experience.
Was you in any of the fight sequences by
any
chance?
Yeah, I was on the beach fight, and I was in the claim to fame was in the beach cafe where Rocker goes through the window. So
wasn't you chucking through the window?
Oh.
He won't say.
I've seen things you've never seen. That's what we need, some
Quadrophenia music. From behind my back, I'm off the beaten track. What is it about the mod culture that you like so much?
I always liked the music. I was in a band when I was 16, and my mum was a mod in the 60s.
Well, you'll love this. The irony of this conversation is my dad was a rocker.
Oh.
True.
Fantastic being a part of all that culture. Is it stuck with you ever since? I mean, obviously, you've still got the scooter, you're still wearing the parka.
Yeah.
Are you still a mod at heart?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah. I think once it's in your blood, I think it stays there. You know?
Yeah, it stays there forever.
Yeah.
Do you want to push start?
I couldn't be any happier if you tried at the minute. Do you know that?
You're enjoying yourself?
Yeah, I love this.
Ah, brilliant.
What would you say your GS is worth today?
Around about 15,000.
Do you know what? As sad as this may seem, if I had 15 grand in a sock drawer, doing nothing, I'd buy that tomorrow.
This is a mob world.
So if you hanker after a bit of mod nostalgia, where can you get your hands on a set of wheels to relive the dream? Well, I tracked down a bloke called Jason in the wilds of Lee Marston on the outskirts of Brum, who's been pouring TLC over Vespas and Lambrettas for years. We'll catch up with him a little later. Earlier on, we showed you some classic scooters from the film Quadrophenia, the beautiful GS Vespa, and the classic LI150 Lambretta. Now, these are works of art. They're museum pieces, and they're certainly not the kind of thing you can find at your local scooter shop. Or are they?
If you thought classic scooters were as rare as hen's teeth, then think again, because in the heart of the Midlands, just outside Birmingham, is a place called Lee Marston, and that's where you'll find JC Scooters. And what these boys know about scooters, well, it's more than the Italians. This is Jason, who owns this business, and what a cracking looking place it is. Jace, where did it all start?
It basically started at my house, in my garage at home, all from a hobby, totally grew out of shape, and now it's become a part and parcel of my life.
And getting hold of the scooters must be, well, it must be really difficult.
Not really. I've developed a relationship with suppliers now in Italy. I get the bikes imported in that state, as you can see
there.
I
mean, that looks like something you throw on a scrap heap, doesn't it, really?
It may appear to at first glance, but to be honest with you, we strip those down completely to bare metal, as you see here.
And they end up looking like that?
Yeah. Then they get prepped off to the painters, and then they come back like this.
Wow. Fantastic. Yeah, it looks lovely.
As you can see, the guys behind me, they're assembling a bike there. We go from a standard to a custom.
Fantastic. Now, I know that's only one side of your business, because all over the workshop are some fantastic new-looking Lambrettas. What are they all about?
Well, basically, they're imported from India. They come to me as they are, already done, already built, already painted, and we put people on the road for less than £3,000.
Fantastic. And that's essentially a new scooter?
It is, yeah. The frame's original, but every part of the scooter is brand new.
Now, you can see I'm chomping at the bit because I want to relive my youth. I want to get out there on the road. Any chance I can have a spin on one?
There might be if you promise not to scratch it.
I can't promise that, but I promise to look after it. How about that?
OK, you got it.
Cheers, fella.
No problem.
Scooter I'm on is one of my old favourites. It's the GP200 Lambretta. Really a sport Lambretta. It was the closest they ever got to what they call their Grand Prix bike. It's got slim down fairings, very, very sleek and very smart to look at with this square headset. Well, believe it or not, they're imported into the country as aged bikes. They're still 1980 Lambrettas built back then, but now in India, they strip them down to the bare metal, they rebuild them, and they're essentially a brand spanking new scooter. JC Scooters get hold of them, PDI them, stick them out onto the road for the likes of me to go and relive my youth. And this is what it's all about, going out a weekend with the posse behind you. Down to the seaside, I reckon. What do you think, Len? Now, once you've got your classic scooter, it's entirely up to you what you do with it. The world's your oyster, really, in terms of aftermarket stuff. If you wanted to, you can put a sports exhaust on, disc brakes, you can put quick-release throttles, double spring clutches, you can make it perform more much like a modern superbike. Or if you so desire, you can go down the classic route. Pop some mirrors onto it, put a Davy Crockett whip aerial on the back, and pretend to be Jimmy out of Quadrophenia.
Yeah, shut up. Now, all this nostalgia's got me thinking. I must have one.